This conference will now be recorded.
Hello. Hello. వినిపిస్తుందా ఎవరు మళ్ళా మళ్ళా ఎవరు మాట్లాడుతున్నారు?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. Today we will discuss about the forensic psychiatry. So, what is psychiatry? Psychiatry means it deals with the study, diagnosis, and treatment of mental illness is psychiatry. Then what is the forensic psychiatry? Psychiatry means deals with the study, diagnosis, and the treatment of the mental illness. The forensic psychiatry means application of knowledge of psychiatry in administration of justice. That is application of knowledge of psychiatry in the administration of justice. That is in the courts, that is in admission of the mental ill patients in the hospitals and the discharge. And what are the responsibilities of the mental ill persons? And then we have to discuss all those things. So psychiatry deals with study, diagnosis, and treatment of mental illness, whereas forensic psychiatry is application of knowledge of psychiatry in administration of the justice. So what is insanity? Is the unsoundness of mind or diseases of mind and personality? These are the person who are unable to cope with the ordinary social circumstances. So insanity means unsoundness of mind and the disease of the mind and other personality, and they cannot cope up with the ordinary social circumstances. Next, signs and symptoms of psychiatric illness. So one is consciousness, memory, thinking will be different always, and perception, emotions also different, and body. These are the, some of the signs and symptoms of the psychiatric illness we have to discuss. Next, coming to the consciousness. It is the awareness of the self and environment. So it is the awareness of the self and environment is the consciousness, and sometimes it is lost. If it is lost consciousness, it is coma, but the disturbance, so confusion, the consciousness confusion, clouding of consciousness, delirium, fugue state, fugue, and disorientation. These are some of the stages of the consciousness when it is disturbed. When it is consciousness is lost, we call it as a coma. Next, what is delirium? This is a 2 months or 4 months question. So it is a condition characterized by disturbance of consciousness. This is a disturbance of consciousness. Condition characterized by disturbance of consciousness where the critical faculty is blunted or lost or associated with impaired orientation and inconsistent or irrelevant thought concepts. So it is a condition characterized by disturbance of consciousness where the critical faculty is blunted or lost and associated with there will be impaired orientation and inconsistent and irrelevant thoughts will become. That is called delirium. So generally the when these deliriums occur is a fever with high temperature and drug intoxication and in alcoholic intoxication. So in because his main is a fever with high temperature, drug intoxication or alcoholic intoxication. So these deliriums may come here, there will be inconsistent and irrelevant thoughts are present and impaired orientation. And the critical faculty is blunted or lost. It is a delirium. Next, coming to the memory, it is the ability to store and read. So, recent one and remote one. So, disturbance in memory is called amnesia, retrograde amnesia, and anterograde amnesia. So, memory is, it is the ability to store and read. The recent and the remote disturbance in memory is called loss of memory, is called amnesia. Retrograde is from long back, and anterograde is from present point. So, confabulation, false interpretation of some recent events. It is called confabulation, false interpretation of some recent events is called. Next, thinking, thought blocking, sudden break of thought. So, circumstantiality, slow talking with unnecessary details, and delirial derailment of thoughts, sliding of the thoughts, and perseveration, repetition of a word or phrase several times. Perseveration, that is the repetition of a word or phrase several times. And stereotype, constant repetition of a phrase and behavior in many different places irrespective of the context. That is, thinking is thought blocking, sudden break of thought, and circumstantiality, slow talking with unnecessary words or unnecessary details, and derailment of the thought is sliding of thoughts, and perseveration, repetition of a word or a phrase several times, and stereotype, constant repetition of a phrase and behavior in many different places irrespective of the context. Next, coming to the delusion, it is a 4 marks question. What is delusion? It is a false belief in something which is not a fact and which persists even after its falsity has been clearly demonstrated. So, delusion is a false belief in something which is not fact. So, you will persist and he believes which is not a fact. And even after his falsity has been clearly demonstrated or proved also, he will not agree. That is, it is a false belief in something which is not a fact and which persists. Even after his falsity has been clearly demonstrated. So, a normal person can have a delusion. So, normal persons also they have delusions, but psychiatric persons also they have delusions. But normal person is capable of correcting it by reasoning power or by his past experience. But the psychiatric person cannot correct it. So, it is a false belief in something which is not a fact. Delusion in insane person is a symptom of brain diseases and it is mainly found in epileptic persons, affective and schizophrenic patients, but not seen in anxiety neurosis and neurotic illness. Generally, it is seen delusions in epileptic patients and affective and schizophrenic patients. Types, there are so many types of delusions. Delusion of grandeur, also termed as delusion of exaltation. Present delusion, feeling of greatness, power, and health. Example, a man imagines himself to be very intelligent, but in reality it is different. So, delusion of grandeur. So, also termed as delusion of exaltation. It is a present delusion, and he feels always a greatness, power, and health. He imagines himself as a rich person, though he is a very poor person, and intelligent, though he is not intelligent. That is, the reality is different, even though he proves it is not correct, but he thinks like that. That is delusion of grandeur, also termed as delusion of exaltation, present delusion, feeling of greatness, power, and health. A man imagines himself to be very intelligent or rich, while in reality it is completely different. Next, second one is delusion of persecution. So, it is an unpleasant delusion. So, delusion of grandeur is a pleasant delusion. delusion of perception is a unpleasant delusion. But it is. The sufferer believes that something bad is going to happen to him. So he always thinks that something bad is going to happen to him. He fears that he may be killed by somebody. That he always thinks. He fears that may be killed by somebody, and the life of the person full of stress. Because of this depression, The sufferer believe always.
Mahindra sir would phone you, sir.
If yes, that he may be killed by somebody, the life of the person become full of distress and helpless. So these persons may sometimes commit suicide also. So here, delusion of grandeur, it is a pleasant delusion. Delusion of persecution, unpleasant delusion. In persecution, he fears that may be killed by somebody. The life of the person becomes full of distress and helpless. Because of this oppression, he may commit sometimes suicide. Next, third one is delusion of inference. The sufferer with the delusions strongly believes that his thought process, activities, and behaviors all are controlled by some external supernatural power. Always, what he is doing, he thinks that is all controlled by some other one, that is external supernatural power. He always thinks like that. That is called delusion of inference. The sufferer strongly believes that his thought process, activities, and behaviors all are controlled by some external supernatural power. Such person, on the basis of some imaginations from that supernatural power, he may commit some unlawful acts also. Next, coming to the delusion of the reference. Delusion of reference. The person believes that people refer to him in a special way. This may create conflicts with the strangers, as he may think that strangers are also looking at him and talking about him. He always thinks. Delusion of reference is beliefs and things that people refer to him. So he always thinks that all people are talking about him and also looking at him. Like always he thinks, the person believes that people refer to him in a special way. This may create conflicts with the strangers, as he may think the strangers are also looking at him and talking about him. That is delusion of reference. Next, coming to the delusion of infidelity. The person who is suffering with the delusions thinks that his or spouse is not loyal to him. That is infidelity. So, sufferer thinks that his or her spouse is not loyal to him. Usually, males are sufferer. The person thinks that his wife does not love him and she has some intimate relationship with some other person, or which the sufferer always torture his wife, even he kill her wife, or himself commit suicide. So sufferer thinks, delusion of infidelity, sufferer thinks that his or spouse is not loyal to him or her. Usually males are sufferers, and the person thinks that his wife does not love him and she has some intimate relationship with some other person. For which the sufferer always torture his wife, even he kill her wife or himself commit to suicide finally. That is called delusion of the infidelity. Next, nihilistic delusion. This is also an unpleasant delusion, mainly found in negative attitude persons. The sufferer always thinks that God is not exist, as well as he also not exist. He always thinks like that. So negative one, an unpleasant delusion. That is called nihilistic delusion. He always thinks that the world is not exist, as well as he also not exist. Next, hypochondrial delusion. Modern people are very health conscious. It is our consciousness creates a delusion that is called hypochondrial. So our consciousness, he has a our consciousness that is called hypochondrial delusion. The person believes that there is some pathology or abnormality in some part of the system or organ of his body, though in reality he is physically healthy. He always thinks, though he is physically healthy, but yeah, he thinks that he is sick. Sometimes he feels depressed by thinking of the different diseases in his body. He becomes helpless and in extreme depression may commit suicide also. Delusion of self-reproach or self-criticism. It is an unpleasant delusion. The sufferer realizes his fault in part. He blames himself for the failure that creates depression, and the person punishes himself by terminating his own life. So, delusion of self-reproach. It is an unpleasant delusion. The sufferer realizes that his fault in past. He blames himself for the failure that creates depression, and the person punishes himself by terminating his own life. Other type is delusion of jealousy, delusion of religion, and delusion of poverty. And the material importance of delusion is it reflects as a mental abnormality, and they are not responsible by their act. Because it is a psychiatric disease, suicide is a major risk in delusion persons. Next, fourth one is perception. We perceive various things around us through our sense organs. Sense appreciation is sensory distortion, macroptia, sensory experience, hallucination and illusion. In this experience, hallucination and illusion are important. These two are again 4 marks questions and 2 marks questions. What is hallucination? So hallucination is a false sense of perception without external stimulus. The hallucination are experienced by many normal people. Visual hallucination, phantom limb hallucination. So hallucination means it is a false sense of perception without any external stimulus. So we will see some examples, then you can understand easily. Hallucination is a false sense of perception without external stimulus. Types are visual, auditory, olfactory, gustatory, tactile, and psychomotor. So we will discuss later all these things. Thank you for today.
Okay, sir.
अरे आगे नौस्ता ना एयरपोर्ट लगा देंगे भागे करना इन्दु का नेवी स्कूल का ऊर्ज डबल बॉक्स आता है तेरी अपने इन्दु के लानो वो